Here's the junior heavy equipment operators. They're digging up the corn. All right.
You cut the full gear. When you're ready, you tell me.
Nope. Yeah, Melvin's gonna demonstrate the gear hook. You say that one's 44 feet? Thanks, Melvin.
Thanks.
That's real nice.
Hey, Leroy.
How you doing?
All right.
You just said, hold on to it.
Here's, this is Teddy's Kansas City Hay Press Lightning. Beautiful job on it. Morning.
Morning, sir. How
are
you doing?
I'm good. How are you? How are you today? I'm Gil. Nice to see you. And here's a really beautiful, what the hell do they call it?
Joy slide valve.
A Joy slide valve engine. That's right. That's got the Joy valve gear on it. Boy, it runs smooth as silk. And I had one of these once. You know, the one thing I remember the most, other than that it was beautiful, it is heavy.
I have to get somebody to help me. I told them, somebody tried to buy it last year. And I said, if you're not coming by this year, because the weight is not bad.
Include you in my video. Larry, I'm Gil Garceau. Nice to meet you.
Pleased to meet you.
This is a magnificent American La France model. Absolutely spectacular. And here's a wonderful rope. Endless rope.
Enjoy.
Endless rope pull steam engine. Are you filming right now?
You can go. Yeah, do your thing, Gil.
All right. Well, thank you, Will. Thank you. Hi, Lori. Good. How are you? What do you say? Nice stuff to you.
Hey,
toys.
Wonderful toys.
Fun to make toys.
Huh?
Fun to make toys.
There you go. Yeah, he's got his inverted beam over there too.
This is basically, he got me started on it. To make this.
I kind of figured that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this one too.
That one too.
And this one too.
Yeah, I recognize this stuff.
And
it can be
fun. That one's perfect. Now I got the players from that or Elmer's and
but from Elmer's?
Yeah, but yeah. Modified a little bit.
Okay.
This is twice.
All right. I'm Gil Darceau. Nice to meet you.
Gil?
Gil.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you. Thanks for bringing all this nice stuff. Here's the man himself, Joe Higgins.
How do you do?
How are you doing today?
Hello, Gil.
Good.
Nice to meet you. Glad
you're
here.
Nice to meet you. Yeah, I'm glad. I'm kind of glad I made it, too. You know, I better pause here. There you go. This is Joe Higgins' display. Wonderful model engines here. Is this running now?
Well, it does run, but I can't hand start it.
Yeah, this one you can,
this
right?
This one will run, but...
Miriam Abbott. Oh, nice. Yeah, leave them all bunched up like that. That's good. That's a beautiful engine, too. Magnet, right?
Thank you.
Yeah, I know a couple of these kids. One of my favorite engines right here. Nice to see you, Scott. My other favorite is right here.
This one doesn't run very well. It's really difficult to time.
Oh, yeah.
But it does run, which is amazing to me that it even runs. What's weird about it is the crankshaft and the piston rod are in the same plane. And any other engine are going to be perpendicular to each other.
Correct. Yeah. How about that?
Somebody's idea.
I had an engine that used a wheel like that for power. And there was no crosshead other than a roller that stuck into the groove on this and made the engine turn like that. It was a drum about that big, with a trench built carved around it.
When you read the patent on this one, and his idea was a marine engine, and he thought that you're wasting a lot of hull space and making it top heavier when you usually put an engine like kind of like that in there.
Right.
His idea is to lower the center of gravity and make it a little more compact. maybe I'll have more of it done next year.
Uh-huh. Did you cut the gears?
I cut the gears.
Nice. All right. That'll be fun.
Yeah.
Wash plate.
There's actually a patent wash model plate for this one. The other ones didn't even, but this one had a patent model and it's in Smithsonian.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
That's what the patent model looks like.
That's right. It looks like it, doesn't it? Cool. Now I'll move on to here. What do we got here? Coming to.
Fred's model just started putting out casting kits for this.
Who did?
Friend's model.
In Rhode Island?
I think it's Rhode Island. Somewhere around
Massachusetts.
$4,000 for a set of castings.
No. Really?
Plus shipping. $150 just for the drawings.
Everyone wants to see stuff, though. It's normal.
How are you doing, Alex?
Good, how are you?
Good, good.
What'd you get? Pete finally sold me a puddle people.
Oh, he did?
Yeah,
oh, cool.
He twisted my arm like this.
Yeah.
Made me buy it.
Yeah, had
pretty
to
neat,
have one.
Yeah. Is that cool, huh?
Yeah.
He's a cool guy,
well, you know,
Pete. Yeah.
Well, Pete is.
Oh, yeah.
You know, Jeff.
So I cut everything and welded it all and drilled it.
Okay.
This is temporary.
Yep.
It's just I was using it, I made it homemade. I used it for the shop while I was testing the pressure in my boiler.
Sure.
Because the boiler needed a lot of work. The boiler had some serious issues. But I got it holding the pressure now. This is going to come off, but I'm going to finish it. And I just
I'll tell you what.
I wanted to make it look pretty at the shop.
Do you know anything about the guy who built it originally?
No. But I just found out.
It needed a lot of work.
I just found out a buddy collector of mine actually owned it before me and got rid of it because he didn't want to do work on it. It was too heavy for him and, you know, it just was impractical. It was too impractical for him.
I want to say congratulations, Alex. I think it's great that you got it and you're taking the time and effort to fix it up.
Yeah.
I think that's really neat.
I got a 1-year-old now, so it's really eating up the time. It's really hard to put the
time
in.
That's all right. They bring a lot of joy in the house.
I want to get this one literally functional and actually display it so it's really an entire something of some sort.
Uh-huh.
And add the full plant. I'm going to put a full plant with generators.
Yeah.
I want to do like turbines or something.
There's Barry. Oh, you firing up the vacuum rotor?
Well, she doesn't want to go right now, but she will.
It will.
Yeah.
Soon as no one's looking.
Yeah.
Hi, Elaine.
Hi there. Where's the mower?
Huh?
Where's your mower?
She's in the hotel relaxing. Part one, right?
And her sister did not like it because he smoked cigarettes or not.
I said something to him eventually when it was quiet and no one was near him. I said, you know, you're filling the whole place up with smoke. We smell it all the way down by the front door. And he says, you do? I said, yeah. He did turn it off when I said that. But I think it ran pretty good today. Hypocycloid. Oh, there's Natick and Wright. The full-size version of this engine is in the entry hall for the steam building at Rough and Tumble for the steam engine check. And this is the only model of it in existence. That looks like a diesel.
It is a diesel.
Yeah. I remember you had it at Rough and Tumble. Good seeing you again. I still say that's one of the coolest pumps ever. Oh yeah, you got the flame record, the big neck. All right.
Remember that engine?
I sure do. Boy, you've done a great job with it. Thank you very much. There's a PM research protocol. Warren Simbor. Here's a drilling engine. And this is the SS Brass Pile. This is the boat that Joe built, I think, over the last year. Thank you. Sure. We're going to take a peek at the inside now. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh, so you got full control when you sail.
Yep.
Nice, nice. I love the finish on the deck. Now here's a real interesting engine. I remember Al Bowers.
Well, that was his design.
Is it? That was him, huh? I mostly remember them for the miniatures. Yeah, my wife fell in love with them. She wanted one. She has a whole collection of miniature steam engines and stuff. This is really neat. Very different. I like it.
Well, I was using the bases with sewing machine frames.
Uh-huh.
And he just said, well, hell, what do you do with that flywheel? I said, hell, I don't know. He said, I want it.
Figure out what to do with it.
He took some junk parts.
Uh-huh.
He put it together and made it work, and then he just quit working on it. And then after he passed away, I got his fix.
Well, it sure works now.
Working now.
Thanks for bringing that. Here's another one. Here's a Creeders. Good size Creeders. It's like a number one improved engine. 5541.
Originally.
I know. I've had a few of these. Yeah. This serial number, same on here, right?
I don't know. Probably is.
Yeah. It's probably around 1906.
Right.
Yeah, give or take a year.
Yeah.
What? all full of trucks and heavy equipment. Over here we have some digging and mining equipment. Guys that bring these trucks and equipment, heavy machinery models to Cabin Fever, went all out this year.
Attention vendors. We will have a brief vendor meeting just after 5 o'clock this evening up in the food area. Please plan on attending if you're able to. We're going to be discussing some pertinent information regarding next year. Again, vendors, please plan on attending a meeting just after 5 this evening up in the food area. Thank you.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Pretty good, thank you. We're going to take a look at some of Ronald McClellan's here.
It's a motor generator.
Yep, here's a motor generator.
Made in the 1800s style for schools for teaching.
And this is made by Gebruder Boss, Fabric Dynamo Electric.
You can see Poland.
Wow. Machine and apparatus. And it runs. I'm going to demonstrate it now.
I didn't hook it up, but I can run a line right here. But I'm going to use your pen to get the control going.
This is a great piece. Next thing, this is how neon works.
There's
there's a Ford buzz coil, and I would light the neon lamp.
I like the one that just all the people
this one. This is a like a school demonstrator. Generator, you see it making a little electricity there for that lamp. Here's another one.
Are you German?
Nope. Nice, bro. Okay, well, this one also works. This is a Wimhurst generator. Now this generator makes static electricity that stores in these jars until it's enough of it to jump the spark gap right there. And this will give you a shock if you hold those, which I'm not about to do. Here's a little telephone style generator. And here's another one with the bell.
Wow.
Go ahead, crank her up.
Thank you.
All right.
This is like a generator.
Yeah.
Look at that.
This is Brent's engine house.
Yeah, one like this would be 9 feet. Now, if you hold it in one hand,
here's Brent's magnificent large Markland machine shop. This thing is a sight to behold. Absolutely magnificent. You can run this on this electric motor or this steam engine. Steam engine's powering it right now.
That'd be dangerous.
In memory of our dear friend Don Faisal, I brought his Stuart number 4 to display here today. This is Polly Holler's project. It's a Stuart Twin Victoria he's working on. He's made quite a bit of progress. And this is a 1930s Jensen big power plant. And I brought that here to display in memory of Howard Chu, another great friend who passed away sadly. And so we wanted to remember him here. And I will show you over on the other side some more memorial for Howard Chu. There's my Reeves Double Pandy, the Stuart compound, the largest Stuart compound. So, yep. And here's a Stuart Twin Victoria, built by a German engineer. There's a Myers gas engine. There's water-cooled Perkins vertical. Here's our friend Tom.
Good morning.
Nice to see you. And in for Howard's memorial, Tom brought this engine, which was Howard's at one time. Now it's in Tom's good hands. And this is, might be, if not the rarest, it's equal to the rarest Jensen ever. It has a seam on the bottom of the boiler, which you won't see on another boiler. And it has a blowdown valve at the bottom of here and a slanted sight glass to accommodate it. And the main feature here is, and the throttle's here instead of here. And this is not a regular piston valve Jensen. This is a very early D-valve Jensen. And it's got a DC generator here with the extended bay. And here's Tom's memorial to Howard. Is that Howard holding this engine? Either that one or one like it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It may be that one.
Yep.
Yeah, it is.
Memory of Howard Chu. Yeah. Howard been coming to Cabin Fever, I don't know, since the beginning with Tom. These guys were lifelong friends. And they've been collecting engines a little more than twice as long as me, I think. And I've been at it 23 years. Oh, shit. Now this is just one of 5 rooms here at Cabin Fever. 11 Expo Center. And you can see the kind of crowds we get here on a Saturday. These engines are with the Arnold family. Here's a Swan. I'm going to get this in slow motion in a minute here. Here's a Marion. This might be a Vespa.
Use engine, Gil.
Yeah.
Paper top.
Oh, yeah. No, it's a working engine.
Yeah.
It had a job at some point.
It had a coal drawer.
Yeah.
We made the meth burner for it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Boy, that air sure is easy to clean up after.
Yeah, it sure is.
Compared to coal and steam.
Yep.
Here's another cool engine. Where'd you find this one?
I bought that out of a collection in Germany.
Is that right?
Yeah, I figure it's probably Second World War-ish.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a great little engine.
Textile engine, yeah.
Yep.
Right over here.
Here's a couple large and interesting cuckoo clocks. Dylan?
Yeah.
I'm Gil. Nice to meet you. This is your collection? Beautiful. Beautiful. I'm going to include this in my video if it's all right. Thank you. And this is your brother? This your brother?
Yeah.
Hi, Dan. Made a little more progress on it.
Yeah, every year.
Yeah, good. Well, it isn't going to happen overnight.
It's supposed to be done this year, but I'm going to say next year.
All right, there you go.
We'll get there.
Yeah, you sure will. Beautiful work.
Thank you.
Excuse me.
it up in my pocket.
Here's another marble pump. Got any extra ones?
I had testing kits over in there.
Oh, I saw that.
Consignment.
You know, I'm a good mechanic, but I am no machinist. I own a lathe that could probably make you a nice plug in about three times the time it would take you. Yeah, I saw the kits there. I like it.
Otherwise, it would just go right out the car.
There he is right there. The man himself. Nice to see you, Scott.
Good to see you.
All right. It's a Heisler, isn't it?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Look what you did. You see that?
I saw that and I got it on film.
That's yours, what you did then.
Yeah, it's running, that one.
There's three engines on there.
They're normally, all running.
Normally there's an M&M here to show how small that is.
Somebody ate it.
No, what happens is over time they disintegrate. I didn't realize that. And I glue a piece of music wire on it to hold it.
They're all little.
What's that?
There's more than I ever saw.
Yeah, pretty close.
No. They're wobblers. They can run pretty sloppy. That's what's cool about them. You know? Thank you.
How tall is that engine?
516.
And the bore?
It's all right here. 46,000 forward stroke. The height is, I got everything here. The port spacing is like 23 in between the center.
A little bit bigger than we could.
Operation.
Well, I gathered you did because I'm identical. The way you were talking.